So I want to talk a little bit about how you use the foot and how to be able to get a little bit more flexibility through the toes. And this is going to be important for opening up the energy that passes through each of the toes. If you have toes that are very tight and restricted, maybe a little bit of arthritis in it, bunion, this is going to be a way for you to start to really make them a lot more supple in what you're doing. So in the set A exercises, we did ball of the foot, heel drop. Ball of the foot, heel drop. And this one, I know for some people is a real challenge to pick the foot up, put the ball of the foot down, and then drop the heel. A lot of people want to put the toes down, and then they just fall out of that. And there's no articulation that comes through my dirty feet, the ball of the foot here. So what I want you to think about is ball of the foot. Now to get there, we can go ball, but then we can come up toe and point it, ball of the foot, and then drop it back down again. So ball of the foot gets placed, up to the toe, ball of the foot, drop. For some people, this can be quite a challenge to move from the ball of the foot to the toe. And if that's for you, then this is a great exercise to just play with so you can build the skill on it. Okay, so now I'm going to go from there. You could do that more times if you wanted. I'm going to take you to the next part. So we're going to go ball of the foot, toe. Now what I want you to do is roll over the top of the toes, back to the toe, ball of the foot, flat. So now that one may not feel so nice when you start, because this first initial going over the top of the toes, your toes may not have done that for a while, and they might be quite stiff. So what you can do with that is just take your time from here, just give a little roll over. You don't want to roll with the ankle out. You want to make sure that it's over the big toe, because usually it's the big toe that's the stiffest. Bring it back down flat. So let's do the other side. So we have ball, toe, roll that over the top, come back up to the toe, ball, and then flat. You can hold it longer. So when it feels comfortable for you to do that, feel free to just leave it there a little bit longer. Bring it back up, ball of the foot, flat. So now if you end up with a toe cramp while you're doing this, that tells you you've got some tightness in some of the muscles that are in your foot. And that means the muscles might not be doing the work you need them to do. So this is a great way as you go over, if it does cramp up, it will let go. So if you just keep repeating, let everything relax, make sure you're properly hydrated so you've got enough water in the system for the muscles to function right, and you'll be able to work over that. Okay, so now we can take that and we can advance it just a little bit more by doing an exercise where we put the foot on the side of the chair. So this would be bringing it over to the side. I'm going to turn so you can see what I'm doing. I have my ankle straight, I have my toes, my dirty feet, stretched out. And this might be enough for some people to get full stretch through the toes. Totally fine. You might just go there, hang out for a little bit, then do the other foot. But what I'm going to do is show you how you can advance that. So from this position, I'm going to keep my ankles straight, and I'm just going to pull my foot so that I can feel where it starts to pull on my toes. And maybe that's far enough, so you can hang out here for a little bit. If you think you could go a little bit further, you can continue to work through. And again, you're doing what you can handle, what your feet can do, not trying to match me. So I've worked on this for a while, took my big toe a little while to get rid of the stiffness, but now I'm able to bring my foot up, and I can actually bring it so my ankle ends up underneath my knee again. Okay, so that would be how you can advance it from that side. You can go back to the ball of the foot, drop the heel. So let's just do the other side so you get a chance to feel that. So you're going to just lay the foot on the floor, making sure the ankle is straight. A lot of people will try to do this with the ankle, and that tells me that the foot doesn't know what signal it wants to have. So you have to figure out how to get the ankle to lie flat. That might be the first thing you work on. So now you've got the toes over, and it may feel okay. So if it does, pull it up just a little bit. You may notice it's a little bit tight there. That's okay, only go that far. But just hang out there for a little bit and then you can let it relax again. So I'm going to take it a little bit further just to walk you through where you may end up. Again, you'll notice my ankle is staying straight, and I'm going to bring it up. So my ankle is still straight, and for me, this now is quite comfortable. I don't have muscle cramps through my arch of my foot or my big toe, so everything is feeling good. But it didn't get there just off the first time. This took me a little while to practice. Okay, when I'm finished, then I can go ball of the foot, just to reverse it, and then drop the heel. Okay, so that is an advancement on foot exercises where you can start to work through the foot, and what you're trying to do is figure out how you can get those toes to articulate through all the range of motion.